Hi everyone, I'm Keith Straw from IDG Enterprise. Big news in the world today after Apple CEO Steve Jobs announced his resignation. So joining me to talk about this is Computerworld news editor Ken Mingis. Ken, how shocking or unexpected was this news when you found out about it?
I think the only thing that was surprising about it was, you know, when the news would come out, because obviously Steve Jobs has had health problems for a long time. He has had a liver transplant, he dealt with pancreatic cancer. It's surprising actually that he has held on this long in the CEO's role. Now remember, in January he sort of stepped aside.
Right.
And even though he showed up for the iPad 2 announcement in March and was at the WWDC conference in June, the day-to-day stuff's really been in Tim Cook's hands for a while.
So do you expect anything to kind of change at Apple now that this has happened in terms of products it produces? You know, Jobs was very involved in a lot of these decisions about the design of the products or what was in them. So, you know, do you expect any of that to change?
No. Actually, I really don't. In fact, Tim Cook sent out a memo not long after he took over, basically telling everybody at Apple, Apple will not change. Mm-hmm. A lot of what Steve Jobs did in terms of the product development and his attention to detail is now baked into the DNA of the company. They know, even if he's not in the room, what would Steve Jobs want? What would he expect? What would he not like? And I fully expect that to continue under Tim Cook.
What else do we know about Tim Cook? You know, he's going to be the new CEO. Do you expect him to be the same kind of dynamic leader that Steve Jobs is? Obviously, it's got to be hard to fill, you know, to follow someone like that.
Yeah, I definitely don't think he's going to be the dynamic leader that Steve Jobs was, but I think he's really good at managing the sort of day-to-day, behind-the-scenes stuff that other people can sort of fill in around him when it comes to sort of presenting products and doing the big videos and showing off the new, new iPad or new iPhone, things like that. Tim Cook's been there for 13 years. He knows Apple very well, and I've seen a lot of discussion about how involved he is in Apple's supply chain, which is interesting because that's how they've managed to keep the iPad and the iPad 2 so far ahead of the competitors. They've locked up suppliers. They're mm-hmm. keeping their rivals out of the business right now. So that means Tim Cook's a smart guy.
Yeah, and so what do you think about the timing of this? Will it affect any products that we may see from Apple? You know, there are rumors of September, October, the new iPhone 5 or the, you know, whatever the new version of that one is. iPad 3 may come out at some point. What, you know, any of this will affect it or
I
not?
I don't think so. No, I don't think so. These products are planned way in advance. And, again, no one knows exactly when Apple's going to release the iPhone 5 or whatever it's called and the new operating system for the iPhone and the iPad. All the speculation is it'll be late September, early October, and I'm sure that's already planned. They knew this was coming. Apple knew that Steve Jobs at some point would be stepping aside, and they're not going to change this for that.
And I know that he'll still be on the board. He'll still be chairman of the board. But just looking back, what do you think Jobs' legacy at Apple has been? You know, I you don't want to say this isn't like an obituary or anything,
right,
but
no.
You know, what do you think his legacy will be at Apple?
I think, you know, what he's been able to do. In fact, it's interesting. I was editing a column that we'll be running later on in Computer World about what Steve Jobs has done since he came back. And the point that our columnist made is that he has been very good at sort of paring back everything in terms of technology and software and hardware to the most minimalist thing that people can use, and that it speaks to his whole drive for ease of use, you know? And I think when you look at the iPad, you look at the iPhone, you look at the operating system, the way he has sort of just taken minimalism and integrated it with everything that Apple does, I think that's going to be one of his long-standing legacies. I also think what Apple's doing right now with touch screens, multi-touch technology, I think that's going to like take them well into the future.
All right, thanks Ken for joining us. Be sure to head to computerworld.com as well as our other IDG Enterprise properties for continuing coverage of this event. Thanks again for watching.
Thanks.